Tell me what time it is. That extra hour, doesn't matter what direction you're going. Woo. So congratulations, everyone who made it on time. And if somebody comes in an hour, tell them to get in line for communion. It is okay. Okay, speaking of time and schedules, during this week, take a look and keep an eye out for our Holy Week schedule. It'll be Thursday night here at 7. Friday, Good Friday, will be a noon service. Saturday, a new service called Easter Vigil. And I got a bunch of stuff written to give to you about that. And then, of course, Sunday morning, Easter morning at 9 a.m. So watch for that schedule. Today, let me say welcome and thank you to our musicians today for our Jubilate service. Marvelous, always glad to be able to worship in this way, and with the style of music that is, I hate to use the word contemporary, because we don't have really good, but modern, and a little more like what we hear on the radio. So glad that we can do this, and thanks Rory and Suzanne and everybody involved in getting this going on, continuing to worship this way. Following worship today is the soup and goodies sale. Pick up if you order, but Margie just told me that there's a lot of extra in the Bethany room, and so please stop in, pick up the extras, this what I saw coming in was like, ooh, nice. So do stop in the Bethany room. Margie, anything else with that that I need?
Thank you.
confess that we are caught in snares of sin and cannot break free. We hoard resources while our neighbors are hungry and cold. We speak in ways that silence others. We are silent when we should speak up. We keep score in our hearts. We let hurts grow into hatred. For all of these things and for the sins, forgive us, Lord. Amen. Out of love for the whole world, God draws near to us, breaks every snare of sin, washes away wrongs, and restores the promise of life through Jesus Christ. Amen.
Forever.
Amen.
numbers. From Mount Hor, the Israelites set out by the way to the Red Sea to go around the land of Edom. But the people became impatient on the way. The people spoke against God and against Moses. "Why have you brought us up out of Egypt to die in the wilderness? For there is no food and no water, and we detest this miserable food." Then the Lord sent poisonous serpents among the people, and they bit the people so that many Israelites died. The people came to Moses and said, "We have sinned by speaking against the Lord and against you. Pray to the Lord to take away the serpents from us." So Moses prayed for the people, and the Lord said to Moses, "Make a poisonous serpent and set it on a pole, and everyone who is bitten shall look at it and live." So Moses made a serpent of bronze and put it upon a pole, and whenever a serpent bit someone, that person would look at the serpent of bronze and live. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We've got a chorus for you guys today that's inspired by Psalm 107. So the music's not in the bulletin, but the words are there, so I'm sure you'll catch along.
Once in the wilderness,
let the redeemed
You were dead through the trespasses and sins in which you once lived, following the course of this world, following the ruler of the power of the air, the spirit that is now at work among those who are disobedient. All of us once lived among them in the passions of our flesh, following the desires of the flesh and senses. And we were by nature children of wrath, like everyone else. But God, who is rich in mercy, out of the great love with which he loved us even when we were dead through our trespasses, made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved, and raised us up with him and seated us with him in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus, so that in the ages to come he might show the immeasurable riches of his grace and kindness toward us in Christ Jesus. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not your own doing. It is the gift of God, not the result of works, so that no one may boast. For we are what he has made us, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand to be our way of life. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The porch. darkness was, yes, you guessed it, a snake. And I mean, we're not talking a little garter snake. We're talking big snake, huge snake, thick and long and stretched out seemingly from one end of the porch to the other. I screamed. The kind of scream that makes your husband come running to wonder what's wrong. And then I made this Herculean leap over the porch and the snake, pushed open the door, dove into the house, and slammed the door again. Now, nervously, I went over to the side of the door where there's one of those windows where you can look out onto the porch. And so I was hesitant, but I went and I looked, and oh my gosh, it was still there. Turns out, it was a gift from one of our little cats who had shared it as a trophy. Yes, it was dead. Thanks be God. And so here we are in our Old Testament lesson, one of those that I start to read. I'm like, oh! God. Come on, God, let's make will say to God, can't we speed up a little? Can't we get going? Can't we move this task or these people or this ministry? And so I'll complain. But you know, chronic complaining to God blinds us or keeps us from seeing the path that God has stretched out before us. Israel's complaints come fast and furious because God wasn't acting fast enough. They didn't want to go around Edom. They wanted the most direct route, even though God was saving them, knowing that they would be slaughtered by their enemies if they went Edom. And they complain and they complain and they complain. Now, granted, there are times in life when our lives become like a pop bottle that has been shaken again and again and again. And it starts to fizz, and you know that when the lid comes off, it is going to go everywhere. And yeah, sometimes need to let off a little steam and maybe explode. And deep disappointments warrant letting that out in a lament, not complaint, but lament to God. But if all we do is let the pressure build, and if we allow it to grow because we're blaming God, it's easy, but ineffective, because it keeps us from recognizing that God is at work in us and around us and through us, even amid suffering. Now, I don't know if it was because of the snakes or because they had just worn themselves out, but the Israelites wake up from their foolishness and they stop their grumbling and they stop their griping, and ultimately they repent of their contempt for God. And God, who embodies and emanates grace, whose prerogative it is to rescue those who are in distress, whose nature it is to bring healing to those who cry out to the Lord instructs Moses to take the very thing that had been an instrument of death, the snake, and to use it now as a means of healing and new life. Make a poisonous serpent, God says. Make it of bronze and put it on a pole. And when somebody gets bit by one of those snakes, the person should look at the snake or the serpent on the pole, because they will be healed. As is God's habit, God brings life out of death. For the Israelites, God brings life renewed out of death. And just as the cross is an instrument of torture, it too becomes the throne of life. Out of great love, our Lord reaches out to each one of us. And God, in reaching out to you, raises you up and pours out upon you immeasurable grace and pours it into the places in us that stir the anxiety and the distress and the bitterness and the place where all those complaints come from. God is present with grace and with mercy and with comfort that ultimately mercy and forgiveness. Out of great love for you, sent his son Jesus into the world. Not to condemn the world, but to save it. And so, even when you and I are mired in sin and distress and questions and complaining, even then, God brings you again to new life. Life together with Christ. There is always a way in the wilderness. There is always healing for a snake bite. There is always guidance amid wandering. There is always comfort. There is always hope. And as Israel learned, there is always the presence of God who turns our grumbling into joy.
God from true God, begotten, not made, of
one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Relying on the promises of God, we pray boldly for the Church, the world, and all in need. Your name is holy, O Lord. Guide your church so that in every situation, your people's words and actions honor your name. Purify the faith of your church, that we would place our trust in nothing besides you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
You judge the nations. We pray for an end to war in Palestine, Israel, Ukraine, and all places filled with strife. Strengthen international efforts to negotiate peace and provide humanitarian aid to people fleeing from conflict. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
You bring healing and hope. We give thanks for physicians, nurses, researchers, therapists, and public health workers who prevent and treat illness. We pray for any who are sick, especially Aloha, Carrie, Amy, Mary, Warren, Sarah, Linda, Matthew, Al, Sandy, Margaret, Marlene, Paul, Sandy, Doris, Pam, Lila, Kim, David, Fern, Harriet, Kathy, Linda, Dick, John, Janice, Lucille, Harry, Carol, John, Joyce, Jeff, and Bill. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
You call us to proclaim Christ crucified. Give clarity to this congregation and our leaders so that we might follow Christ beyond our own habits and comfort. Clear out anything in our common life that would obscure the gospel or that serves our own interests. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
You call us to proclaim the good news of Christ to all the world. We give you thanks for all those involved in global mission as they demonstrate the love and compassion of Christ in word and deed. Bring your blessing to the ministry of young adults in global mission, our companion synod, the Evangelical Lutheran Church in Jordan and the Holy Land, and all of our partners in ministry, whose ministry extends to every corner of the globe. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Your cross is power for all who are being saved. Thank you for all whose witness reveals the power of the cross. Give us the same trust in life and in death. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We entrust ourselves and all our prayers to you, O faithful God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us share a sign of God's peace.
Jesus, you are the bread of life and the host of this meal. Bless these gifts that we have gathered, that all people may know your goodness. Feed us not only with this holy food, but with hunger for justice and peace. We pray this in your name.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior, Jesus Christ. You call your people to cleanse their hearts and prepare with joy for the Paschal feast, that renewed in the gift of baptism, we may come to the fullness of your grace. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Lord, we pray that in your goodness and mercy, your Holy Spirit may descend upon us and upon these gifts, sanctifying them and showing them to be holy gifts for holy people, the bread of life and the cup of salvation, the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, all glory and honor are yours, Almighty Father, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, both now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Amen. Christ is given and shed for you. Amen.
When music fades, and all is stripped away, and I simply come, longing just to words no one could express how much you deserve.
strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen.
Generous God, at this table we have tasted your immeasurable grace. As grains of wheat are gathered into one bread, now make us one loaf to feed the world. In the name of Jesus, the bread of life. Amen.
Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless and keep you now and forever. Amen.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found, was blind, but now
share your bread.
Thanks be to God.
My chains are